next paper is Clinical Epidemiology of Hypernali Zara, that's the hump-nosed viper, envenoming in Sri Lanka. The paper is by Ratnayaka RMNKN, Ranatunga PEAN, Kularatna SAAM, and the paper will be presented by Ratnayaka RMNKN.
I am going to present my research study, that is Clinical Epidemiology of Hypernali Zara, that is hump-nosed pit viper envenom in Sri Lanka. Hump-nosed pit vipers, in Sinhala it is called Kunakatwa and Porontelis or Porontelis sub, which includes the genus Hypernali, are the commonest cause of venomous snake bite in Sri Lanka. It accounts for the 22% to 77% of the all venomous snake bites in Sri Lanka. The genus comprises three species called Hypernali Zara, and Hypernali Nipah. Hypernali is the commonly encountered species in Sri Lanka, which found all over the country except in the peninsula of Japan in the north. Hypernali Zara found in lowland rainforest and therefore it's called lowland hump-nosed viper. Hypernali Nipah found in central hills in the country, which is the more than 1,000 millimeter altitude. This shows that the map shows that the Hypernali, Hypernali Zara, and Hypernali Nipah, three species of hump-nosed viper distribution. We saw that except Jaffna, in other districts, the Hypernali can be found. But Hypernali Zara and Hypernali Nipah only found the central hills, which include Sabrakamuwa and the central points. This is the three species of the hump-nosed viper. Upper picture, this is Hypernali, lower two, Hypernali Zara and the Hypernali Nipah. We know that in three species all look like in naked eye, but careful examination can be divided in three species. My objective was to describe clinical and epidemiological features of Hypernali Zara bites in a wet zone of Sri Lanka. The methodology, this was an observational clinical study done in teaching hospital Ratnapura. Data collection was done for 5.5 years, commencing from June 2015, using an interviewer administered questionnaire. Results: all hump-nosed viper bites in my study was 480, which is 27%, out of that Hypernali 300, that's 75%, Hypernali Zara 22%, and Hypernali Nipah, which is the lowest, is 3%. Of Hypernali Zara bites, 65 patients were males and 38% were females. The mean age was 43.1 year, and most of bite occurs in lower limbs in daytime in home gardens. Majority of patients, that is 41%, was admitted to hospital within 1 to 2 hours of bites, and their mean hospital stay was 2.5 days in hospital. Considering clinical profile, all Zara and minimum was 100 patients, that is 95%. The dry bites, that is, there's no any features of imminent features, in spite of having fang punches, and patient brought the specimen, there's a 5%. Local limbs, they have considered lower local enveloping, they have 100 patients, and systemic effects were observed in 5 patients. They have non specific features in the 23 patients, which is a 22%. That is fever, abdominal pain, nausea, vomiting, that is a non specific features. Other local envenomation, there's a local pain, local swelling, local bleeding, bruising, lymphadenopathy, necrosis, and blistering. Local pain and swelling also again divided into three groups, that's mild, moderate, and severe. In local pain, there's a 38%, there's a mild pain, 28% moderate pain, and 34% severe pain. Systemic effects. There were three patients with acute kidney injury, and 2 patients with microangiopathy hemolysis, and one patient with venom-induced consumption coagulopathy, and 1 patient with thrombotic microangiopathy, and 1% patient with variant angina, that is Prinz metal angina. Laboratory findings, the eosinophilia is the was the significant finding, which is 20, there are 26 patients, and there's a leukocytosis, neutrophilia, HGO, liver enzyme elevation, hypokalemia, hypernatremia, and derangement of clotting profile and high creatinine, elevation of creatinine levels. Most important thing is that there's no antivenom in Sri Lanka for hamnose fiber bites, but there are systemic effects. And my study, the results are compatible with previous studies, which is most available is regarding the hypnale bites. In this study regarding hypnale sara bites, new findings are the microangiopathy, hemolytic anemia, thrombotic microangiopathy, and variant angina. Conclusion of my study, the hypnale sara bites cause mostly local lengthening warming, and only few get systemic effects. On hematological findings, the eosinophilia is a significant finding. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Dr. Ratnakar. The paper is now open for discussion. You have 3 minutes.
The patient liver microangiopathy,
hematical,
that's
hemoglobin,
the kidney disease also,
same
patient.
Yes, one patient, and he developed into a thrombotic microangiopathy as well.
Patient survived?
Yes, with dialysis and plasmablasis, patient got fully recovered.
Yeah, no antivenom was given. The other antivenom that is available?
Not indicated.
Yes.
And the eosinophilia is a persistent finding even in previous studies?
No, the previous studies, these hematological findings are not evaluated. And this study,
that's what I hadn't seen. So, eosinophilia, you are reporting it for the first time in your group?
Yes.
These complications, can you tell us the definitions? What are the criteria for identifying them? For example, weak. How did you identify weak in those patients? Or did you have any criteria?
Find it by species?
No. Mm-hmm. Now, those complications that you look for, like acute kidney injury, VICC, and so on.
Yes.
What are the diagnostic criteria for each of those things?
Yes, in acute kidney injury, we measure the urine output and the biochemistry, serum creatinine and bilirubin. When the urine output less than 0.5 milliliters per kg per hour. That's, and with the elevation of the serum creatinine, that's the guidelines. And also in VICC.
So, what is the guideline? Is it like one single elevation or is it rise in creatinine?
Rise in creatinine.
What was the rise and how often were they done?
That's a acute kidney injury, that's a 48 duration, that's a elevation of the more than normal level.
Just a single finding?
Yes.
Just one blood report?
One.
Okay, right. What about VICs?
And coagulopathy, we look for the protein profile, that's a PTI, INR, APTT, and the clotting test, blood clotting test. When the INR more than 1.5 and APTT more than 25 and the clotting test more than 20 minutes, we call it the venom induced consumption coagulopathy.
Okay, right. VICs? What about angiopathy?
So microangiopathy, we evaluate that it's a blood picture the crenated red blood cells more than 2% high power field. We consider that the microangiopathy hemolysis.
And
classical
blood picture also, no? Classical
yes.
Thank you, Dr. Ratnakar.